Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on in, come on in. Come on in. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you. Come on in, come on in. Come on in and share this broadcast. Let everybody know that we're on. Come on in, come on in. Anybody blessed this morning, come on in, church. Hallelujah. Come on in. Come on in and see the creek. Let's share this worship so we can get together. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Anybody blessed on this great morning? Hallelujah. Amen. Come on. Let's share this broadcast. Amen. We're blessed today. Glory to God. And I'm going to share it while I'm sitting right here. It don't take too much. Just go to the bottom of the broadcast and click share. And put it on your page and let people know that we're in worship this morning. Amen. Anybody blessed this morning? And just type when you share it, join us in worship. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on in, come on in, come on in. Amen. Cedar Creek, welcome. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we have come to rejoice and be glad in it. Anybody glad to be in the house of the Lord today? And you may be saying, Pastor, I'm not in the house of the Lord. I'm at my house. Wherever the Lord is, that's the house of the Lord. So you can make your house the house of the Lord right now. So come on and let's share this broadcast. Let's like it, comment, tell me, hey, how you doing, so I can know that you're out there with me today, that we are coming to give God glory. Wherever we are, we can praise God. Hallelujah. Like I said, David told us that we can bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in our mouth. He didn't say a place. He didn't say a place. He just said a time. And the time is all the time. And right now is a time to praise the Lord. And so your place is wherever you are right now. You're at your house, you're at your job, or you might be in your car. Wherever you are, you can praise God because we serve a great God. Hallelujah. How many know that our God is greater, our God is stronger, our God is wiser than any other? So let's go into a little bit of praise and worship and give God glory today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise the Lord in this place. Hallelujah. Come on, our God is greater. Our God is wiser. Our God is stronger than any other. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Water, you turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. There's none like you, yeah. Come on, help me say, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Our God is wiser. Yeah, our God, awesome in power. Our God, said our God. Hey, come on, give him glory. If you know that you serve an awesome God, if you know that you serve a powerful God, yeah, into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, out of the ashes, there's no one like you, Lord, there's no one like you, Lord, oh, our God is greater, our God is stronger, Lord, you are. Oh, our God, awesome in power. Say, give him power, because he is wonderful. Then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand? Come on, say, and if our God, then who could ever? And if our God is with us, I'm here to tell you, he's with us. There's nothing. God is for us, so who can be against us? Oh, God, and nothing can stand. Hey, come on, come on. Then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God, then who could ever stop us? And if our God, then who can stand? He's awesome, he's mighty, and he's strong. Hey, our God is stronger. Our God, yeah, our God is healer, awesome in power. Oh, said our God, come on and bless his name. Come on, if you know that there's nobody greater than our God, come on and give him glory right now in this place. Let's go before the Lord in prayer, right? Wherever you are, if you're in the home with somebody, join hands, let's touch and agree, and put your prayer request on the screen right now. Whatever you need the Lord to do, you put it right there, and I believe that God will see it, hallelujah, because he already knows what's in your heart, and he will do it for you, and we're going to agree with you on whatever it is that need that you need from the Lord. I need prayer. I got some stuff I need the Lord to do, so I'm asking God to do it for me, hallelujah. I dare you just right in your house, wherever you are, say, Lord, do it for me right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to tell you thank you. Thank you, Lord, for all that you have done. Thank you, Lord, for every way that you have made. You've been good. Hallelujah. Down through the years, Lord, you've been good to us. Lord, even we got to bring it to down through these last few months, Lord, you've been good to us. So today we say thank you. God, we thank you for another opportunity to worship you. We thank you for another opportunity just to bless your name, God, and to come into your presence, because we know in the presence of the Lord, there is the fullness of joy. And at your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. So we thank you today for your grace. We thank you today for your mercy. We thank you today for your power. So God, whatever it is that the people need, whatever it is, God, you know what I need. We say, Lord, do it right now in the name of Jesus, God. Give us a peace, God. Give us a grace to endure, God. So we thank you right now because we know your grace is sufficient. We thank you right now because we know your mercy covers us. We thank you right now because you love us. So we just thank you for being God. We thank you for how you care for us each and every day, even in the midst of a pandemic, even in the midst of sickness, even in the midst of struggle, even in the midst of trouble. We know that you are greater. Hallelujah. You are stronger. You are wiser. You are higher than anything that we are going through. So we take our focus off of our issue and we place it on you. God, we need your help right now. So we say, come, Lord Jesus. We need your strength right now. So we say, come, Lord Jesus. Come into our lives. Come into our homes. Come into our families. Come into our marriages. Come into our children. Come into our finances. Come on our jobs. Lord, we need you right now. God, heal the land. God, heal the land. Do it for us right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, if there's anything that's not like you in us, remove it right now. God, we confess our sins to you, God. Sins of omission and commission. Those things that we didn't even know that was a sin that we did. God, bring it to our minds so that we might not sin again. God, so we thank you, God, that even though we have sin, that as we come to you and we confess to you, you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. God, we thank you that we don't have to stay in that place. We don't have to stay in that mess. We don't have to stay in the hog pen of sin. We, as prodigal children, we can come back home and we know that you are waiting with your arms wide open, ready to receive us. So we come today to you. We come to Jesus. We come to your son. We come to you, oh God, and we thank you for just being a part of our lives. You are the best thing that ever happened to us. So God, continue to have your way in this service. God, use me for your glory. Use me for your power right now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you and we praise you. And it's in Jesus' name that we do pray. Let everybody say amen. Come on, clap your hands and say amen. I dare you to type amen. You should feel better because that's power in prayer. All right now, this is our giving time. Glory to God. The Bible loves, God loves a cheerful giver. Hallelujah. The Bible says we give and it shall be given unto us, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. See the creek, you're ready for the overflow? We know that it's not a seed that we, a debt that we owe, but it's a seed that we sow. Hallelujah. We're putting a good seed into a good ground, expecting a great harvest. So right now, Lord, we just thank you for everybody that you have provided for. Not just you have provided for all of us. And we thank you, God, for an opportunity just to be able to give back to you a portion of what you have given to bless your kingdom on this earth. So right now, use your phone, whatever you need to do. Use Givelify or you can use Cash App to give your offering today and be a blessing to the kingdom of God. Amen. And if you're at home and you don't have access to either one of those, contact one of your younger members of the church or your younger members of the family so they can help you how to set that up, or call your deacon or trustee, somebody that you know, that they will come safely with a mask on and some gloves and pick up your offering, and so that you can be a blessing. We know, as I was saying at Brooklyn Baptist when I grew up, you can't beat God's giving no matter how you try. Amen. So go ahead. This is giving time right now. We thank God for the offering. We thank God for the giver, and I ask God that he bless you and give you back everything, a 100-fold blessing on what you have sowed into the kingdom of God. Amen. We thank God that each week that you all come online. We thank God that each week that you are sharing. So right now, go ahead and share. That you are sharing this broadcast, letting people know, amen, that you are proud of your church, that you still love your church, and you want others to be able to receive this word that's about to come forth. So it's word time. We're going right into it. So go ahead and share this right now and let somebody know it's time to get in the word. We're coming from Psalm 141 today. So go ahead and share this and let somebody know it's word time in the house. Glory to God. Anybody need a word? I don't know about you, but I need a word in my life. Hallelujah. The word is what's going to keep me. The word is what's going to give me strength. So right now, get in your word. Get your Bible out. I know you got your phone that you're watching on your tablet, but find your paper Bible somewhere so you can get in this word. You know, I like to walk through verse by verse. So let's get in the book today. And we're in Psalms 141. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And we thank you and we praise you. Glory to God. Psalms 141. Amen. Psalms 141. And before we get into the word, to just set my mind straight, to set our minds on worship, I'm going to sing this song that says, because of who you are. And a lot of times we praise God for the gifts. We want the presence. And I heard Bishop Brian Moore say this on my way coming to church. We want the presence, P-R-E-S-E-N-T-S, of God, but we don't want the presence of God. That's the one with the C-E at the end. We want his presence, the things that he can give us, but we don't want his presence. So somebody out there, you should be able to praise God just for who he is and the beauty of his holiness, hallelujah, just because he is God and because of who you are, we give you glory today. So let's just spend some time in worship. Let's just spend some time in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and give him glory. Hallelujah. Come on, if you're at home, you can lift your hands. You just open up your heart and just begin to bless the Lord and give him glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Yes, Lord. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are. Because of who you are. Come on, help me say, because of who you are, I give. Come on, lift your voice and say, because of who you are, I give you praise. Say, because of who you are, because of who you are. Yes, and Lord, I worship you, yes, because of who you are. Hey, you're Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Yes, God. Said Jehovah Nissi, Lord. Say, Lord, you're reigning. Hallelujah. Let's get right into this word. Amen. Psalms 141. I'm going to be reading from the NIV version, and then I'll be going to the Life Application Study Bible. It says Psalms 141. I'm going to read the whole thing, so that's why I need you to get your Bible so you can read with me. It says, I call to you, Lord, come quickly to me. Hear me when I call you. May my prayer be set before you like incense. May the lifting of my hands be like the evening sacrifice. Set a guard over my mouth, Lord. Keep watch over the door of my lips. Do not let my heart be drawn to what is evil, so that I take part in wicked deeds. Along with those who are evildoers, do not let me eat their delicacies. Let a righteous man strike me, that is a kindness. Let him rebuke me, that is oil on my head. My head will not refuse it, for my prayer will stand against the deeds of evildoers. Their rulers will be thrown down from the cliffs, and the wicked will learn that my words were well spoken. They will say as one plows and breaks up the earth, so our bones have been scattered at the mouth of the grave. But my eyes are fixed on you, sovereign Lord. In you I take refuge. Do not give me over to death. Keep me safe from the trap set by evildoers, from the snares they have laid for me. Let the wicked fall into their own nets while I pass by in safety. Verse 1 again, I call to you, Lord. Come quickly to me and hear me when I call you. If I had to take a title, my title would be Hurry Up, Lord. Hurry Up, Lord. And you might be saying, Pastor, you can't hurry God. But how many of you have ever been in a situation in your life that you said, Lord, I need you to hurry up. I know you're coming. I know you may not come when I want him, but you're always on time. But Lord, I need you to hurry up. And I'm in a situation I need him to hurry up. You in a situation you need him to hurry up. God, I need you to do a quick work in this. God, I need you to do this for me. And I need one of them suddenly blessings that I read about in the Bible. You might not change the situation, but God, hurry up and change me. Because, you know, sometimes God will, he won't change the situation, but he'll change you. And he'll change the way you handle it. You might be saying, well, God, I need you to do something to this person. I need you to change this person. God, he might not change that person, but he will change you. So your prayer should be, Lord, hurry up and change me. Hurry up and change how I handle this. Hurry up and change how I deal with this. Because, you know, you ever ask somebody to do something for you, and you've been waiting, and you've been waiting, and you've been waiting, and you've been waiting forever. And you're like, I sure wish they hurry up, especially if they come in to go somewhere. I wish they hurry up and come. I wish they hurry up and do this. I wish they hurry up and do this. I know his thoughts are not my thoughts. I know his ways are not my ways. But God, I need you to hurry up. And this corona thing, God, I need you to hurry up and do something. I know that's been your prayer. God, somebody said, I need to hurry up and get back to work. I need to hurry up and do this. God, I need you to come quickly to me. And there's nothing wrong with that. David showed us here it's all right to have these type of conversations with the Lord. David was a man of prayer. David was a man of praise. And that's why I'm always drawn to him, because he had stuff going on in his life and he wasn't ashamed to let people know. He wasn't hiding. He wasn't doing all this stuff because we knew all about his problem and through his prayers. We knew all about his pain through his praise, because he knew that it was no need hiding. There was no need hiding from God. When you come to God, it's no need of hiding what you're going through, because he already knows. He knows what you did. He knows what you said. So just come clean to God. And David says, Lord, I call to you. Come quickly to me. Hear me when I call to you. You ever call somebody? They'll pick up the phone. You know they home. You know they got that cell phone. You know some people like me. If you ever call me and I don't pick up, I might not want to talk to you, or I don't know, because I always have my phone on me. You know, people say, well, I don't have my phone. I was doing something else. Sometimes people just don't want to talk to you. But I'm so glad, glory to God, anytime I call upon the Lord, he'll hear me. Hallelujah. I'm so glad anytime if I have to pick up my spiritual phone and call on the Father, he will always answer. Aren't you glad that you got somebody that's always there to hear your cry? Aren't you glad that you have somebody that's always listening to you? David said, I call you, Lord. Make sure you hear me when I call. I know you pick up the phone, but you know, sometimes folk talk so much, you be on the phone, but you listen. Tell the truth, shame the devil. They just talking and they talking, and then they be like, you listen to me, but I heard it. You really ain't heard nothing that they said. You just want to hurry up and get over with what you're saying. God don't get tired. Glory to God. That's real bad English. God does not get tired of us. Give him your thoughts. Give him your concerns. Give him your issues. You know, he wants to hear all about your problem. He wants you to give it to him. And once we give it to him, that's when we say, Lord, hurry up. Come quickly to me. David says, verse 1 again, David says, I call to you, Lord. Come quickly to me. Hear me when I call to you. May my prayer, I told you David was a man of prayer, be set before you like incense. May the lifting up of my hands be like the evening sacrifice. Glory to God. It's a whole lot just in that verse right there. Let my prayer be set before you as incense. The lifting of my hands as the evening sacrifice. So David was saying he used the smoke and the smell of incense as a representation of his prayer to God. You see, incense, you know, when you light them and they have a fragrance. And not only do they have a fragrance, sometimes the incense, a smoke will come out the incense. And most of the time, the smoke in the incense goes up. It goes up. The smoke doesn't go down. It goes up. And so David says, when my prayer is the lighting of an incense. Incense was a part of Hebrew ritual and a part of a sacrifice of things that they did. And incense was offered every morning. We look at Exodus and we can look at Numbers. It says incense was offered every morning and evening before the Lord on the golden altar. Before the veil of the sanctuary. That was a part of their sacrifice. That was a part of their worship. That was a part of their time coming before God. They lit incense. So David says, I'm not actually lighting an incense to get your attention, but my prayer is sending up smoke. Glory to God. My prayer is sending up a sweet smelling savor in your nostril. My prayer is sending up to you something you will enjoy. And you know, back in the day, I think you still go now, go to the flea market and you can get those incense. And a lot of times people would buy them to bring a certain smell in their house. You will, either you want a smell to come in or you want a smell to go out. And so incense, if it smells good, it will make your home smell good. It will get any bad smell out of your house. And if you cook something that had a bad smell, you will burn an incense to take that smell out. God, David's saying, Lord, I got all this stuff in my life. I got some bad smelling stuff over here. I got some bad smelling. This situation don't smell too good. That right there, that one stinks. Ooh, and that one, that smell real bad. But God, in my prayer, I'm lighting the incense. God, in my prayer, I'm sending up smoke to you. I'm sending up a fragrance to you. Regardless of my situation, God, hear my prayer. Hear my cry unto you. Glory to God. As just like the smoke from the incense rise to the air, your prayer rises to heaven. Glory to God. And when you pray, you please God. Prayer pleases God. God wants you to talk to him. God wants you to bring him your cares. God wants you to bring him your concern. So when you pray to him, you are pleasing to God. The Bible says without faith, it's impossible to please God. So if you turn it around, that means with faith, I can please him. So how else can I demonstrate my faith but then to pray to the one I believe in? Glory to God. When you pray, that's an act of faith because you are praying to somebody you can't see. Glory to God. You are praying to someone you have never actually touched with your hands. You are praying to someone you've never seen walk in your house. But faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. I know that he lives. My word tells me. I have experienced for myself. I might not see him with my eyes, but I believe. And because I believe in him, I have faith. And because I have faith, I will
talk to him. And when I talk to him, I am praying to him. So when I pray to him, I am giving him something he wants. Hallelujah. Give God what he wants today. Give him your life. Give him your heart. Give him prayer. Pray to God, because prayer still matters. Hallelujah. Prayer matters. T-shirts coming soon. All right. Prayer matters. I want everybody to know that when you pray to God, glory to God. Hallelujah. He hears it. And let me tell you one more thing. Prayer needs some fire. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 James 5 and 6 talks about the effective, fervent prayer, the powerful prayers of the righteous avail of much. Put some power behind those prayers. Because let me tell you something. An incense it's not any good unless you light it. I don't care what kind of essential oil is on that incense. I don't care what they dip it in. If you don't light it, you will never get the full power of what it is. Glory to God. There is so much power in prayer, but if you don't do it, you will never reap the benefits of prayer. There is so much power in talking to God. There's so much power into communicating with him, but if you never put it into work, that's why the James ought to say, faith without works is dead. Glory to God. There's a lot of power in faith, but if you never activate your faith, you will never receive the power that God has for you. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all the power that we could ask, according to the power that worketh within us. You've got to light the fire that's within you. You've got to light the fire that's within you. So once you light it, glory to God, that powerful prayer, that earnest prayer, when you get on your knees or standing up wherever you is and you just cry out to God, that effective prayer, that fervent prayer, that consistent prayer, it sends up smoke. It sends up a sweet-smelling savor to the Father. Pray, church. We've got to pray, church. We've got to pray. David said, Lord, I cry unto you. Make haste to me. Come quickly. Give ear to my voice. Hear me when I cry out. Let my prayer be set before you as an incense. So David shifts from his prayer to his praise. Glory to God. He says, because let the lifting of my hands, glory to God, hallelujah, may the lifting of my hands be like the evening sacrifice. See, back in the Old Testament days, they had to sacrifice different things in order to get into the presence of God. They would cut a calf or whatever, or they would burn incense, or they would bring different things to the altar to get into his presence. Guess what? We don't have to do that anymore. Glory to God. Because when Jesus' blood was shed on Calvary, he was the ultimate sacrifice. And therefore, we don't have to make that type of sacrifice. But they talk about the sacrifice, which is the fruit of our lips, which is our praise. That's the only thing we got to sacrifice today. And David was prophesying, glory to God. Even before Jesus came, even before he died, David said, Lord, let the lifting of my hands, glory to God, be like the evening sacrifice. I don't have nothing to cut up. I don't have nothing to put on your altar but me, glory to God. I'm bringing myself to you, and let my praise, hallelujah, glory to God, be like the evening sacrifice. God, let the clapping of my hands be my sacrifice. Let my shout be my sacrifice. Let my dance be my sacrifice. You got to learn that there's power in prayer and there's power in praise. If you gonna make it, you got to pray. If you gonna make it, you've got to praise. If you gonna sustain this quarantine, you got to pray. If you gonna make it out of this pandemic, you've got to praise him. You've got to pray to the Father, and you got to praise him. Praise shows God that you believe what you prayed for. Hallelujah. God, I may not have it just yet, but my praise says I'm ready. Hallelujah. I may not see it just yet, but my praise says, Lord, I trust you. David says, let the lifting of my hands, come on and lift your hands and say, Lord, I thank you for what I need in my life right now, because I know only you can do it. Glory to God. David said, God, I need you to come quickly. But while I wait for you, I'm going to pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, I need you to hurry up, but I know it's in your time, God. I know all that, but while I'm waiting on you to come, I'm going to pray. I hope my prayers hurry up. I hope my praise push you to come a little faster, because you got to know how to get through. Thank you, Jesus. You've got to know how to come out of what you are in. And the two things, prayer and praise. Once you believe, pray. Once you pray, praise him. Faith. I need to add that faith, prayer, and praise. You believe God enough to pray to him. And then once you pray, your belief in him makes you praise because you know he's going to do what you need for him to do.
Hallelujah.
So let's go on to this scripture. Let's go. Verse 3, it says, set guard over my mouth, who Jesus, and keep watch over the door of my lips. David says, okay, Lord. All right. Okay, I'm praying and I'm praising. But God, set guard over my mouth. Tame my tongue. That's what James told us. See, keep watch over the door of my lips because I don't want to say something to mess up what you are doing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, growing up, the old folks would say, don't let your mouth write a check. Y'all know how to finish that. Because you don't want your mouth to get you in something that you can't get out of.
Hallelujah.
So if God is working on your situation, if God is working on your problem, Lord, hush my mouth.
Hallelujah.
Don't let me grumble and complain. Don't let me say, well, Lord, you're taking too long. Don't let me say, Lord, well, I don't know how. Lord, set guard over my mouth. Keep watch over the doors of my lips. Because don't you know that this thing here is powerful? This is so powerful. It says the power and life and death are in your tongue. And sometimes you are killing stuff that needs to live. And you are letting stuff live that needs to die. You need to get a hold over your mouth. Lord, help me say what I need to say. Lord, help me not to say what I don't need to say. A lot of us, if we need to ask the Lord to do this a long time ago, we wouldn't be in them situations. Ain't nothing wrong with being quiet. It might bother some people, but ain't nothing wrong with being quiet because sometimes you don't know what to say or sometimes you don't know how to say it the right way. And those are times where this old hymn says, blessed quietness. We need to find that blessed quietness. Some of us talk too much about nothing. And sometimes people can't handle what you're going to say in that moment. And so if the Lord tell you to hush, hush. Set guard over my mouth. Keep watch over the doors of my lips. The door. See? David, use some good imagery there. Hallelujah. The door of my lips. Sometimes you need to close that door. Hallelujah. Close it and lock it. People are like, well, what you got? I ain't got nothing. Mm-mm-mm-mm. Well, I ain't got nothing. God ain't released me to say it. So when he releases me and when the door opens, you can say the right stuff. You can speak what the Lord speaks. You can speak what God has said. You can speak the word. But until that time, Lord, close that door. Hallelujah. Close the door of my mouth. I don't want my mouth to mess up my prayer. My God. I don't want my lips to mess up my praise. That's why, you see, you got to, if you know the script, you got to tie in everything. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. David, that's why David puts, he said, I'm putting a praise in my mouth so nothing else don't come out. Put a praise in your mouth. Hallelujah. Put a praise in your mouth. Because sometimes what comes out your mouth don't need to come out your mouth. Hallelujah. But if you're praising him, and if you're praying, and if you're thanking him, you don't have time to grumble. You don't have time to complain. You don't have time to be nasty. You don't have time to be rude. You don't have time to be condescending. You don't have time to be negative, be doubting. Because in your mouth is a praise. So God, if you allow this door of my mouth to open, only thing I want to come out is a praise. Hallelujah. Only thing I want to be able to say, thank you, Lord, for doing it for me. Thank you, Lord. I know we're going to have thoughts in our minds, but everything that's in your mind don't need to come out your mouth. Hallelujah. Let me say that one more time. Everything that's in your mind don't need to come out your mouth. So verse 3, you might need to put that on a sticky note and put it on the mirror in your bathroom and put it on your car. When we go back to work, put it on your cubicle. Set guard over my mouth, Lord. Keep watch over the door of the lips. Just say, Lord, shut that door. Oh, my God. Because I don't want my mouth to mess up what I am trying to do through you. So, Lord, I really need you to hurry up and do that, because this thing here can get me in trouble. But, Lord, if you watch it, my God, and if you give me the ability to tame it, God, I can make sure I don't mess up what you are doing. Because David said, there's a lot I can say, but there's a lot I don't need to say. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because all these people trying to kill me and I got all these issues, but that ain't what I need to say. Because flowing out of my heart is gratefulness. So that's what I need to come over all of my problems, over all of my issues. What I need to say is, Lord, I thank you. What I need to say is, Lord, I bless you. If I'm crying out, Lord, I need to cry. Lord, I need you. So watch what you say. Glory to God. Watch what you say. Hallelujah, because everybody can't handle what you say. God. So he moves on. He moves on. He says, do not let my heart be drawn to what is evil, so I take part in wicked deeds. Along with those who are evildoers, do not let me eat their delicacies. So this is where we bring it home. Because a lot of times people in church, we run church people away. We want the people that need to be here away, because guess what? We act like our stuff don't stink. We act like we don't sin. You act like you were saved out your mama's womb, speaking in tongues, shouting and do all that stuff. You act like you don't have any problems. No, David knew that he was human. David knew that his spirit was willing, but his flesh was weak. And so therefore, David says, do not let my heart be drawn to what is evil so I can take part in their wicked deeds. We are living in an evil world. So you got to pray, Lord, do not let my heart be drawn to what is evil so I can take part in these evil, wicked deeds. David knew this because he had experienced this. He is writing this out of experience. Why? Because did you remember David followed his heart? When he had an affair with Bathsheba. David followed his heart, his so-called, see, you got to know that your heart is wicked if you don't allow the Lord in it. His heart was what told him, and his mind working together told him to kill Uriah, to cover up because he had got that woman pregnant. His heart was what got him in the place that he was, that child that she was pregnant with, it died. But his heart was what got him back to God. Glory to God. He said, Lord, create in me a clean heart. Renew a right spirit in me. Because what I did, it was in my heart. But my heart had become wicked because I had allowed the evil world to draw me in. Glory to God. Don't you let it draw you in. I know it looks good. I know it smelled good. And I know you heard people say it was good. But don't you let it draw you in. God, don't let me get in that mess. God, don't let me go down that road. God, don't let me do it. So, because I want to take part, but I don't need to take part. Hallelujah. My flesh says go, God, but I need my spirit to stand up and say don't go. My flesh wants me to do that, but my spirit needs to say, no, you can't do that. So your prayer is, Lord, don't let my heart be drawn to what is evil so that I can take part in wicked deeds, because there is no life in that. The Bible says there is a way that seems right to man, glory to God, but the end thereof is death. But hallelujah, it also says the wages of sin is death. But don't stop right there, because there's joy in that. But the gift of God is eternal life. Hallelujah. So you've got to know there is sin in the world, but you don't have to partake in it. Hallelujah. You can turn from sin. You can resist the devil and he will flee. You don't have to fall into a pit. I won't take part in wicked deeds along with those who are evildoers. So you got to make sure. I'm not talking about separate yourself and cut everybody off, but you got to separate yourself from situations that's going to take you back to some place that God hasn't delivered you from. Or take you to somewhere that you ain't strong enough to handle it. Because they are evildoers in the world. They want you to have a good time with them. They don't want you to succeed and go no higher with them. So when you decide you don't want to do that stuff no more, they try and pull you back in. But your prayer is, Lord, don't let my heart be drawn to what is evil. I have the capacity to do it, but God, I need you to stop me from doing it. Take that desire away from me. Do not let me eat of their delicacies. David is saying, it's good. Don't even act like when you was out there in the world doing what you was doing, you wasn't having a good time, because you know you a liar. But David said, I don't want to go back to that. I don't want to go back to that situation. I don't want to eat at the enemy's table. God, I want to take pleasure in his kindness. Let him rebuke me that is the oil on my head. And that's what I have come today as a righteous man of God over your life right now. I have come to tell you the word of God that's correcting you. And the correctness of God is not harsh, it's kindness. And the correction of God is the anointing on your life. So allow God to change your life. Allow God to correct you. Allow God to get you together so you can be who he wants you to be. He says, it's all on my head. This is verse 5. Because my head will not refuse it. I want the anointing. Hallelujah. Anointing fall fresh on me. Hallelujah. Anoint me, God, because I know I'm going to another place. I'm going to a higher level, but I can't go there without your anointing. So anoint me afresh right now. Holy God. Come on, God. Anoint me with your word. Anoint me with your power. Anoint me with everything that I need to go higher in you. For my prayer will still be against the deeds of evildoers. I'm praying against the devil. I'm praying against the enemy, not just for my life, but against him in your life. I don't want him to attack you. I don't want him messing with your family. I don't want him messing with your finances. I don't want him messing with your body. I rebuke the devil, and I come to declare and decree that the devil is a liar, and right now, as you are lifting your hands, he is taking your hands off. He is taking his hands off of your stuff. You are released. Woman, thou art loose. Man, thou art loose in the name of Jesus Christ. You don't have to be bound by the enemy. You can be free today in the name of Jesus. Prayer. David, see, he's going back to prayer. But my prayer will still be against the deeds of the evildoers. And even David, David got real plain. And he said, Lord, their rulers will be thrown down from the cliffs. The wicked will learn that my words were well spoken. They will say, as one plows and breaks up the earth, so our bones have been scattered at the mouth of the grave. Talks about what they need to do, what's going to happen to them. And then he talks about how they are talking about how the people of God, bones going to be scattered about the mouth of the grave. They're wishing evil on us. But guess what? Even when somebody is wishing for your demise, even when the enemy is trying to take you always all the way out, he's trying to kill you. Because the Bible says he's come to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. That the devil is walking around like a roaring lion, seeing whom he must devour. But don't you know that he just might be a lion? But we serve the Lion of Judah. We serve the King Lion. You know, in the Lion King, there was a lot of lions, but Mufasa was the king, and they bowed down to him. And so, therefore, we serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So I don't care what the devil is. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. And so you got to know, like David tells us in verse 8, and I've been saying this for the last couple of weeks, we've got to fix our eyes on him. He says, but my eyes are fixed on you, sovereign Lord. In you I take refuge. Do not give me over to death. God, I know where to go in trouble. Hallelujah. I know where to go. Death is calling me, but I know I can't go nowhere until you're ready for me to go. So death, you're going to have to go because you don't have no power. Death, where is your sting? You don't have a sting no more. You don't have victory over me. I got victory over you because of Jesus Christ. So therefore, my eyes are fixed on the Lord, and I take refuge in him. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run in, and we are saying, my God is my rock and my refuge, a very present help in the time of trouble. You've got to know where to go when you're in trouble. Verse 9, David said, keep me safe from the trap set by evildoers, from the snares they have laid for me. There is some traps out there. For the snares they have laid for me. I know you might not have seen, if you never hunted before like me, I've never hunted before, but I've seen traps, bear traps, and different type of traps to catch animals out there. It's like a metal clasp that if you put your foot in it, it automatically claps on your and you fall down in it, and snares and different like that. It's to capture you. The enemy's trying to capture your mind. He's got snares out there. He's got traps out there to cap your mind. But every trap, hallelujah, that the enemy set, it won't work. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus Christ. And every tongue that rises against you
coming, God, in the name of Jesus. And David said, let the wicked, this is verse 10, let them fall in their own nets. Hallelujah. There's an old song, I think it was Clearwater. Somebody said, the ditch you dig for me is going to be the one you fall in. I'm here to tell you, quit trying to set people up for failure, because you might fall in that own trap. But I come to tell you, God is going to keep me from falling. Now unto him that is able to keep me from falling. Let the wicked fall into their own nets while I pass by in safety. Hallelujah. I'm in the safety of the Lord. You are safe today. Glory to God. Hurry up, Lord. But Lord, while you're doing it, I'm going to be praying and I'm going to be lifting up my hands, glory to God. Because my prayer is going to be like an incense, and the lifting of my hand is going to be like the evening sacrifice. Faith. Prayer. Praise. Because I believe you, I can have a conversation with you and give you all of my problems. I can worship you. And then just say, Lord, I need you to do it. But then after that, I can praise you because I know you will do it. Thank you, Jesus. My faith tells me to ask you to do it because I believe that you can do it. My prayer is me asking you to do it. My praise is me trusting that you will do it. Hurry up, Lord. Come on, do it, Lord. I call on you, come quickly. But my prayer, my faith, my prayer, my praise is gonna keep me until you do it. I know you've been praying. I know you've been believing God to do it, and it hasn't come yet, but keep on praying. Keep on believing. Keep on praising and know that God is going to come through for you. Only God will do it. The enemy is going to come. But guess what? David said, let the wicked fall into their own nets while I pass by in safety. Hallelujah. You coming out of this. Hallelujah. You coming out of this. You ain't going to smell like or look like what you've been through. Because what to come is better than what's been. You just trust God. You keep on praying. You keep on believing. You keep on worshiping. You keep on praising God. And all I can say is watch God. Hallelujah. Watch God do it. Hallelujah. Watch God make a way. Watch God work a miracle. Watch God do it just for you. Anybody believe that God can do it? Somebody just type, I believe it. 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 I believe that God can do anything. I believe that whatever it is that I'm asking for and praying for, I believe that God can do it. My faith makes me believe. My prayer makes me ask. And my praise shows that I can trust him. God, I trust him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I give him glory today. You ought to give him glory. Praise him right there in your house. Tell him thank you. Praise him in advance. I'm not going to wait till the battle is over. I'm going to shout right now because I'm coming out of all this stuff the enemy trying to do to me. God is covering me. God is protecting me, and I'm going to pass through safely. But don't forget, ask the Lord to cover my mouth. Lord, close that door so I won't say something that's going to mess up my destiny. Don't allow the words that come out your mouth mess up your destiny. Don't mess up what God is doing because you won't be quiet. Be quiet. Be still and know that he is God. I'm not telling you not to pray. I'm not telling you not to praise. But don't say nothing or don't do nothing that's going to mess up your prayer. Don't say nothing that's going to make your praise in vain. Trust God. Have faith. Pray to him. And give him praise. Hallelujah. 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 Whatever it is, God can do it. There's nothing too hard for God. Trust him today. And we are coming out of this thing as pure gold. And come on, let's give God praise, hallelujah, and let's thank him for what he's about to do in your life. Praise him in advance. Cedar Creek, we love you. I love you. And I'm praying for you. And those of you who are sick in our church, we are praying for total restoration, healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And you know, the announcement came from our president that churches, the governor should open back up churches. We are not
going on his word. We are moving by what God says, and we're watching what the data says. We're not coming back in here until it's totally safe. Amen. I'm not going to put myself, my family, or you in harm's way to catch something just to come to church. Because this church is still open. We've been praising God ever since this thing started. Amen. The church is open. Hallelujah. The building may be closed. We can't worship like we used to, but God has made a way that we can still worship him. And I believe that God is moving even in your homes right now. So we're going to trust God and we believe in him. When it's time for us to come back, we will. But we ain't moving by man. We are moving by God. So stay safe. Stay prayed up. Be wise, but don't be in fear. Why? Because God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and the love and the sound mind. Let us pray, and I'm going to leave you alone. I'm going to let you go and enjoy your day. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. I bless you today. Thank you, Lord, that I call upon you, you will answer. Hear my cry, Lord, and come quickly. Make haste to me. God, I thank you, God, that you hear me. God, I thank you today that I can pray to you every day. I can send up a sweet-smelling savor to you. I can lift my hands and give you praise as my sacrifice. God, I thank you for just being God. You know exactly what we need. You know the desires of our heart, God, and we are delighting ourselves in you right now that you can do it for us right now. God, you know what to do. So just be God. Hallelujah. Be God in our life. Give us strength. Give us courage. Give us the power to do all things, because we can do all things through your son, Jesus Christ, that gives us strength to do them with. God, I thank you for Cedar Creek. I thank you for some of the best people in the world. I thank you for the best church in the whole wide world. God, keep us together, keep us united, and let us know that whether we're at home or even here in the sanctuary, that you are still God, and that we are still doing your work by praising your name, God. So I thank you that we will bless you at all times, and a praise shall always be in our mouth, regardless of where we are. God, we know that we can still give you glory. So keep us, God. Let this day be the best day of the best week of our lives. Let us see signs, wonders, and miracles in the name of Jesus. We thank you today, and we love you, and we praise you, and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Come on and give God glory. Give God praise. Go and be blessed and enjoy this beautiful day. But be safe. Amen. Bye-bye.